You know, I know that today God is going to really speak. And before we get started, I wanted to tell my mom if we could make a quick prayer so that, you know, God could glorify himself.
Oh, yes.
And so that, you know, just I really do believe that people are going to find their destiny or at least start looking for their destiny. And I truly believe that God is in this place today. You know, I started doing these lives and a lot of it was, they told me, oh, you're great motivating, you inspire people, you do so many great things. And it was great, it was true. But, you know, God is just taking things kind of in a different perspective so that it's great. I do love to inspire. I do love to motivate people. And that's just part of who I am. I'm very passionate. I think I came from a very passionate family. And, you know, at that aspect, it's kind of like, wow, this is what God is doing. And today's topic is so dear to me because there's so many people out there that really do not know what they're doing here. Mm-hmm. They kind of trying to identify, why am I here? Why am I born? Why, you know, what's the purpose that I have here? Some people that are listening to me are 20 years old, other people are 40, other people are 50, 60, still not knowing why they're here, you know? And I really want to share with people and kind of, you know, make you understand what it was for me and why, you know, I know that God has really been taking us to another level. They really been taking a place of liberation, a place of deliverance, a place where it's kind of like, wow, you know that God is there no matter what. And I am having a little bit of an issue, but I don't think as on your side is on mine. Yeah.
Because it's the weather.
The weather?
Yeah.
Because it's the weather. Christine, do you see us fine? Or Myrna, if you guys are there, could you just, I'm really excited about the word that I'm going to share, and I want to make sure that you can see us nicely here. Let me see.
Yeah.
Okay. We're good. We're good.
Jesus.
Okay. So as everybody starts joining, I want to, you know, encourage you guys to share. So many people, really hundreds of people watching these videos. And I really do feel from God that God has called me to really share a different perspective on life, on success, on just really the will of God upon your life. And as you guys know, let's make a little prayer. Lord, in the name of Jesus, I glorify you. I honor you. I ask you, Lord, to stop any distraction from anyone that needs to hear the word of God today. I pray, my God, Lord Jesus, that this video will be shared, not for me, not for fame. I rebuke the devil that is trying to tell that to somebody. It's for that people could know that the word of God exists. Yes. It's so that people could know that Jesus is real. Mm-hmm. It's so that people could know that they have a purpose in this life and that they should not just be living or existing, but they really should start embracing the journey that God has for them.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. And I just pray as the people that are coming in and watching, I want you to share the video. I want you to, you know, DM it to people, send it to other people, you know, message to individual, to a group, because I really do feel that this message today is going to change people's lives. Yes. I feel people that are suicidal are going to listen to this and are going to say, I want to live again. Yes. I feel that people that just really do not know their purpose in life are saying, you know, after listening to this, I have a purpose.
Yes.
Okay. I know that there is something that God has for me in my life.
Yes.
And I want to move forward on it. I no longer have fear. I believe that God is going to break chains of fear. They're going to break chains of anxiety. It's going to break chains of just panic, of being in fear. You know, I mean, where this is the middle of the year. We're still working on this pandemic, still working on whether things are going to be open, whether, you know, I just got an email from Yankee Stadium because I cater to a lot of my customers, and they're saying, oh, you know, if you're not vaccinated, you can't go. You're going to sit in a different place. You're going to do this. So they're trying to figure out vaccination, no vaccination, trying to figure out, do we open, do we not open? There's so many encourage you today that the only stable thing that there is God. Yeah. He's always been stable. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. He's sitting on the throne. He knows what's going on. He knows what you're going through.
Amen.
And he is going to meet you wherever you are at. He's going to meet you wherever you are at.
Yes,
okay, so God bless everyone. This is episode 44, Life with Gina, Becoming a Better You. And just excited about today's title, You Need It. Why you needed to be born. Why you needed to be born. So I just want to share with you these next 9 episodes. Now is 8 episodes, right? I wrote a book called Prevail, The Process of Overcoming. I wrote it in Spanish. I wrote it in English. And I also did audibles in Spanish and in English for those that don't want to read or those that prefer listening to it. You know, is wherever books are sold. I give all the glory and honor to God that he allowed me to write this book that is started as a book to talk about my mom and how she's living the best days of her life and have overcome so many obstacles that I'm sure some of you can relate, some of you can't. Some people have read the book and said, oh my God, how is this woman living? How are we living? How are we surviving as a family? Okay, but today, what I decided to do and what the team really decided to do is talk about different chapters in the book that I think were extremely impactful for people. I want to tell you, we started this journey in 2019, July, August of 2019, and January 2020, the book was out already in publishing all over the stores, all over publications and Amazon and anywhere where books are sold. And all that is glory be to God, you know. And the reason why I share this is because you also have a destiny of what God wants you to do. There's something that God wants you to do that might be a little bit daring, might be a little bit different from what you're used to, might be a little bit different from what your family is used to doing, might be a little bit different and you don't know how to start. I'm telling you, if God called you to do it, just start. God will open the doors. He will find people that are going to guide you, that are going to take care of you. But if he called you, right, if he has given you the vision, he will provide the provision. I know that without a shadow of a doubt. That is for somebody out there. I want you to say amen, because it is for somebody, for you to understand that if he gave you the vision, he will provide the provision. Today, in the book Prevail, The Process of Overcoming, we are going to talk about chapter 4. And chapter 4, the title of the chapter, okay, it's called I Needed to Be Born. That's the name of the chapter, right? I Needed to Be Born. I don't know if you can see it there. Mm-hmm. I Needed to Be Born, mm-hmm. Chapter 4. The reason why God, I remember sleeping in my bed, and I'm asking God, what am I going to write about in this book? I know that I wanted to write my mother's story. I wanted to talk about inner healing and a lot of things that I have seen my mother really overcome. And God spoke to me in my heart, and he talks to me a lot in dreams. And in this night, I was actually in a convention and I was doing a couple of things for my business. And I woke up and God told me, you needed to be born. I needed to be born. So for those that don't know, I am the youngest of 4. Okay. And I have an older sister and 2 older brothers. And I brought my mother in this episode. She was not scheduled to be in, but she is an honorary guest. She can be here every single week if she wants to. I brought her in here because I wanted her to share a little bit of her experience when I was born. When you read the book, you're going to see what she was going through when she had her first child, second child, third child. But then here I come along, 4th child. And I want her to explain to me a little bit about what she was experiencing. Because honestly, even from the seed, the devil wanted to kill it. okay? Mm-hmm. Even from the seed, even from the thought that, oh my God, there's gonna be a fourth child. The devil is only out here to destroy. He's out there to kill, okay? And to steal. And don't lay back and think that the devil is looking to destroy you, okay? Because he's doing whatever it takes so that the destiny that God has for you is not being fulfilled. So I want my mother to share. So what was the situation at the point that I was going to be born? And what was going on through your mind?
Verdaderamente, la situación mía era una situación bien miserable.
My situation was a very miserable one.
Una vida llena de, una vida vacía, una llena, una vida aunque yo estaba sirviéndole al Señor, pero eran tantas las problemas que yo tenía en mi matrimonio, tanta la soledad que tenía, a pesar de que tenía a mi esposo, pero era como no supiera porque él siempre estaba afuera. Y era una situación bien triste cuando yo supe que Ginar, que yo estaba encinta de nuevo.
So it was a very sad time when I found out that I was pregnant. Although I was serving the Lord, I was not in a financial situation to have another child. Mm-hmm. My relationship with my husband at the time was not flowing emotionally. I was not stable. And could I say that you didn't want to have me? Point, okay. Mm-hmm. And what happened?
Sí, cuando yo supe que estaba encinta, yo decía que como que no estaba preparada para tener otro niño, porque lo estaba criando prácticamente sola, con tantas situaciones, mm-hmm. y con, tú sabes, y yo, en vez de sentirme contenta de que estaba encinta, lo que hice fue que me puse triste. Yo dije, mm-hmm. wow, yo no quisiera ni que este bebé naciera en la situación que yo estaba pasando. No era en sí porque el bebé iba a nacer, sino cómo yo me sentía.
Right. So at the time when I was pregnant, she's saying the way I was feeling was not comfortable enough for me to say, wow, I want to bring another child into this house. I want to be, you know, I don't think I'm really doing everything possible so that another child could be born. So at a certain time in her mentality was like, well, maybe I shouldn't have this fourth child.
Mm-hmm. Pero ese eran los planes que yo tenía, pero Dios siempre tiene un plan mejor que el que nosotros tenemos.
So when she, you know, that was the plan that she had, but God had a very different plan. So the reason why I share that is because you're not always born in the right situation. Right, some people are born with a silver spoon in their mouth, and they're like, "Oh wow, you know, everybody's prepared, and you have, you know, a baby shower, and the baby shower after the baby shower, and the reveal, and you know, everything is perfect for this baby to be born, and maybe you're the first in your family, and you don't have any need, and you have your room ready before you're born." Well, in my situation, it wasn't really like that. In my situation, right, my mom was going through financial issues with my dad. Emotionally, she wasn't stable. She didn't feel that she was capable of bringing a fourth child into the home. She had thoughts of maybe not having me, but she did anyway, right? There was a bond eventually that she was like, I'm going to have the child. So what made you say, I'm going to have her? Or I'm going to have the child, because you didn't know it was a girl.
Me puse a hablar al Señor. Le dije, bueno, Señor, sí. Sí, yo estoy encinta, tiene que haber un propósito, aunque yo no lo veo ahora, uh-huh. porque emocionalmente, como yo digo, no me sentí estable, o sea, no me sentía feliz, no me sentía como preparada para no llevar al bebé, pero que yo dije, Señor, ella está ahí, yo no voy a cometer un aborto, porque aunque yo no quería tenerlo, pero ese no era una alternativa, sino right. que está ahí, pues tiene que nacer.
Right, so she didn't feel she had any alternative. She didn't want to get an abortion, but she prayed to the Lord. Mm-hmm. And she said, well, if this is your will, then this child is going to be born.
Yes.
And, you know, I just made the decision to want to have the child. Mm-hmm. So the greatness of it is that, you know, I was born. and in a midst of a crisis. I was born in a midst of a financial situation. I was born in a midst of, you know, not a lot of resources, but for some reason, one way or another, I was born. Amen. And I just want to let you know that while I was writing this book, a lot of the things that I was experiencing were very surreal, because I was kind of going through the emotions that my mother was going through. And God kept on telling me, you need to write this book because so many people are going to be blessed. You need to write this book because you needed to be born for such a time like this.
Yes.
And the reason why I share that with the people, I am just so tired of people just existing. There's a reason why you are here. And I'm very passionate. I feel the Lord as I speak to you on Facebook and on Instagram, mm-hmm. because there is a reason why you're here. It doesn't matter. God doesn't look at all the mistakes you've made. God doesn't look at your situation right now. Mm-hmm. He is not looking at you as a human eye with human eyes. He's looking at you through the grace of God. And that's what we mistake, that God is looking at you through the grace, through his grace. And he's saying, yeah, maybe you went through situations. Maybe you don't know why you're here right now, but I want to let you know that right now you do have a purpose. I don't care if you're 5. I don't care if you're 50. I don't care if you're 80. You still have a purpose to be here. And we're going to talk about that today, because I think a lot of us don't realize what is our destiny. And we're just living to live. Okay, we go from gossip to gossip, from situation to situation, from problem to problem, without really doing something significant in this world. And I just want to let you know that we all have a calling.
Yes.
Okay. We all have a calling. It says, you know, that not too many are chosen. But the reason why it says that is because not everybody is fulfilling the calling that God has given them, right? But we all have a calling in the midst of this world. Yeah. We all have a ministry. We all have a destiny and where we need to be. So the goal is, when I was writing this chapter that I needed to be born, I realized, wow, although I was born in a situation where maybe there was no financial no financial resources, or maybe there was no real, like, wow, I'm so excited that I'm gonna have a baby, or my daughter was like, oh, the fourth kid, you're planned. You know, I wasn't planned. I wasn't, you know, none of that matters. The point is, I'm here today. What are you gonna do being here today? Okay, all of those circumstances are just circumstances that happened while you were being born or while you were being raised. There's a lot of us that were raised, maybe we were abused, maybe we went through situations that you were like, but that was not my fault. And maybe it wasn't your fault, but God is going to use that and turn that around so that now you can be a help for other people.
Yes.
And that was one of the things that my mom was talking about last, our last episode. And she was talking about, you know, God is going to show you what your ministry is according to what you have gone through in your life. Okay, but one of the things that I wanted to share today is, when I was writing that chapter 4, I started realizing, wow, God is a God of destiny. He is a God of purpose. He is a God that he just lines things up. And think about a situation you have been through. You're like, wow, you know, although I didn't understand that happened, but when you look back at the situation and you're out of the problem, right? Has that ever happened to you?
Oh,
like,
yes.
If you look back at the situation and you're out of the problem, you realize, wow, God really orchestrated that the right way. God really, really did what he needed to do at the right time. He brought the right people at the right time, took out the right people at the right time. He did everything he had to do, yes. So that today I could be where I'm at.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And those are the situations that you need to start thinking about in your life. Could you tell me an experience that maybe you've gone through that you say, wow, I couldn't understand it at the moment. I questioned God at the moment. I thought I was never going to get out of it. And then when you got out of it, you realized, oh my God, it was all in God's plan.
Exacto. Y todo estaba en la mano del Señor.
And everything was in God's plans.
Porque Dios tiene control de cada situación en nuestras vidas.
And God has control of everything in our lives.
Mientras nosotros estamos pasando por las pruebas y por las situaciones, nosotros entendemos el porqué.
When we're going through trials and tribulations, sometimes we don't understand the why.
Yo digo que todo el tiempo no entendemos.
That many times we don't understand.
Cuando termina el proceso, entonces Dios nos dice, mira, yo tuve que hacerlo de esta forma.
Yes.
Para que tú estuvieras en este lugar en este día.
So when the process is over, then God tells you, listen, I have to do this and this and this so that you could be here.
Exacto.
In this situation
Dios
right
no
now.
Dios no se equivoca.
God does not make mistakes.
Cuando, aunque nosotros cometemos mistakes.
And although we make mistakes.
A veces en el medio del proceso.
In the midst of the process.
Nos llenamos de ira.
We get filled with anger.
Nos llenamos de venganza.
We get filled with revenge.
Nos llenamos de odio.
We get filled with hatred.
Empezamos a pelear con Dios.
We start fighting with God.
Al menos que debemos pelear con él, ¿sabes?
And the last thing you should do is fight with him, but.
Pero somos así los humanos.
But that's the way we are.
Pero tú sabes, en medio de si no hay proceso, no hay un carácter, no hay un desarrollo,
yes.
No hay un crecimiento.
If there's no process, there's no development, there's no growth.
No desarrollas el carácter.
You cannot develop your character.
Porque en cada proceso hay un crecimiento.
Because in every process there's a growth.
Y no solamente un crecimiento, sino que hay una enseñanza.
And not only a growth, but there's also a teaching.
Y esa enseñanza va a ser de bendición para tu vida y para aquellos que están a tu alrededor.
And that teaching that you're going to go through is not only going to be for you, but it's going to be for the people that are around you.
Yo le decía al Señor, qué de bueno yo voy a sacar en esta situación que yo estoy pasando.
I told God, what good am I going to go through the situation that I'm going through in my marriage?
Pero yo no sabía que dentro de mi situación yo vivía una vida miserable, vivía una vida seca, vivía una vida vacía, vivía una vida no había control en mi vida. Después que pasó todo el proceso, yo ahora soy una mujer estable.
Right. So I have to tell you that while I was going through the process in my marriage that I couldn't understand why, God, you're making me go through this. I was miserable. I was unstable. I was depressed. I was anxious. I didn't know what to do in my life. But then when the whole process was over, then I found myself stable.
Exacto, porque digo, Señor, gracias porque me ayudaste y aunque yo no entendí, me estabas ayudando y me estabas guiando en medio del proceso que yo pasé.
Although I didn't understand what I was going through, God was guiding me and making me go through this situation so that I could become who
exacto.
I am today.
Y no es que Dios tenga culpa de las situaciones. Nosotros somos los con las decisiones que nosotros hacemos, nosotros somos los que marcamos nuestra vida para bien o para mal.
Yes, and you know, with the decisions that we make, we either mark our lives for good or for bad.
Solamente que la misericordia de Dios, aunque cometamos errores, Dios está ahí para ayudarnos y para levantarnos.
The only thing that the grace of God is there to lift us up, no matter what we go through.
El amor de Dios es incomparable.
The love of God is not comparable.
Mira, el Señor no tiene una mano acusadora para decirte, oye, que bien lo hiciste, que bien, mira cómo lo has hecho. No, el amor de Dios está extendido para levantarnos y para ayudarnos. Y para a pesar de que hacemos malas decisiones, y estoy hablando de malas decisiones, pues cuando yo era una muchachita, mami me decía, tú nunca vas a ser feliz. Y no era que me estaba maldiciendo, era que como madre, ella estaba mirando lo que iba a pasar en mi vida. Pero cuando usted sabe que cuando uno se enamora, cuando uno es muchacho, cuando uno se cree que lo sabe todo, ustedes entienden, ¿verdad? Hacemos las malas decisiones y después tenemos que pagar las consecuencias.
You know, when she was growing up, she made some bad decisions in her life. And I say that because when her mother told her, you're never going to be happy, she wasn't cursing her. It was just that she saw the situation beyond yes. with her wisdom. Mm-hmm. And she told her, if you marry this guy, this is what's going to happen to you. Exactly. But when you fall in love, sometimes you don't see that. You're exactly. blind. You're hoping for the best. But the parents always know the best for the children.
Exacto. Yo no sé para quién esa palabra o si tú hay una muchacha o un muchacho que nos está escuchando en este momento y tú vas a hacer una decisión y tu papá y tu mamá te dicen no lo hagas. No es porque ellos no quieren que tú seas feliz. No es porque ellos se estén metiendo en tu vida, aunque tienen que hacerlo porque son tus padres. Es que ellos ven más allá de lo que tus ojitos puedan ver y te quieren evitar un problema bien grande. Pero como nosotros somos así, ahí caemos.
So I just want you to understand this word might be for somebody. If you are going through something and maybe you're young or maybe you're not that young and your parents are telling you, listen, you need to be careful with that. I don't see a good outcome with that. You know, your parents are there to guide you. Yes. They're there to pour wisdom in you. They're there to make sure that you're doing the right thing. So be careful. Yes. If your parents are saying, hey, that's not the way, and you keep on going that way, but your parents are saying, go this way, and you keep on going that way, you're going to pay the consequences exactly. for it.
pero que en medio, como estamos hablando, ¿verdad?, del proceso, porque todos nosotros tenemos que pasar por ciertos procesos,
yeah,
aunque nosotros no lo busquemos muchas yeah veces, y aunque nosotros lo busquemos, en medio de ese proceso está Dios ahí para levantarnos, para enseñarnos y para darnos crecimiento y para mostrarnos cuál es el destino que Él tiene para nosotros, porque Él tiene un plan perfecto para nosotros.
Yes, God has a perfect, perfect plan for us. And a lot of times we go through these situations because you need to find out what your destiny is. You need to find out what your calling is. And that's what we're going to talk about today, because, you know, for everybody that's listening to me, whether you're serving God or not, you have a destiny to be in this world.
Yes.
And, you know, you have to figure out what is your contribution.
Yes.
What is your contribution to this world, to your community, to your surroundings, to the people around you? And, you know, I realized that when I wrote that chapter, I was like, wow, if I would not have been born, who would my mother be with when all the children left and I was the only one left behind? Yes. Because when she went through what she went through, the hardest part of it was, you know, everybody else leaving. When my father left, you know, my brothers were still there. My sister and I were still there, but shortly after they left, mm-hmm, you know, they got married, they did their own thing, and I was the one staying behind. So I remember that, you know, my mother was, when her father passed away, you know, I was the one there guiding her and saying, Ma, you know, this is what happened. I got your ticket. Let's go to Puerto Rico. Your father passed away and I'm here for you. When things happen in her life that, you know, a husband was the one that was supposed to be there, God had given me the ability and the courage to share with my mom and tell her, listen, this is what we're going to do. This is how we're going to do it.
Yes.
I remember when she got sick of asthma and she didn't know what to do. And she's like, why do I keep on getting sick? And I praise the Lord that God healed her from that asthma because she couldn't breathe at night. And I remember sleeping with her and I couldn't sleep because she was with the coughing and she was with the breathing. And I remember God liberated you from that.
Oh, yeah.
And God healed you in that aspect. I talk about that in the book, but I remember telling myself, wow, I had a reason to live. And you need to find that reason why you are here. You need to stop listening to the lies of the devil that you're not worth it, that you're not supposed to be here, that there's no reason for you to be here. You should take your life. You need to start listening to those spirits of suicide and rebuke them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And realize that you do have a purpose to be here. You might not know, maybe you just graduated college and you don't know what you're supposed to do. Maybe you don't know what career you're supposed to take. Maybe you don't understand, you know, what you're supposed to do, but understand that God will guide you even in the midst of your fogginess or confusion. And maybe you're going through that because God is saying, get involved with me and I will show you.
Yes.
Pray and I will show you.
Yes.
Start feeling the Holy Spirit, the comforter that I have left. While I'm in, you know, sitting in the right hand of the Father, go search for the Holy Spirit so that He can guide you and tell you what you need to do.
Yes, yes.
This is why most of us don't know our destiny and our calling. This is why there's a lot of us not knowing why we are here. We're just kind of existing. We're just trying to figure out, okay, what is the next Netflix show I'm going to binge on? What is the next job I'm going to get? Where's the next state I'm going to move to? You know, what's the next boyfriend I'm going to have? And we have no destiny. We don't know what we're doing with our lives. We don't have no purpose. We don't wake up with meaning. We wake up like, it's just another day. And God is here to tell you today, stop it. You have a reason why you are here.
Exactly.
You have a reason why you are here. For those people that you know that just don't know what to do in their lives, they don't know what their ministry is, what their calling, what their career. I need you to share this video because today we're going to pray over you so that you can start understanding your passion. Tanil, thank you for sharing. So you can understand what your passion is. What do you like? Start paying attention to yourself. What do you like? What is your passion? But I want to share this with people. This is why, this is one of the main reasons, in my opinion, why people, I've been praising God. I've been fasting. I don't have a voice. I haven't been in a church in deliverance, doing deliverance for hours, but I think I've been doing it on myself every morning. Okay. And I'm like losing my voice. All right. But I wrote this down because we lose it sometimes. We forget that we have all been called. We have all been called. This is in Mark 16:15. And he said to them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to all creation. Mm-hmm. If you don't know what's your specific calling, Let's do a global calling. That's your calling. That's all of our callings. Okay, yeah. He told them, and he said to them, go into the world and preach the gospel to all creation. Wherever you're at, even if you're working in Starbucks, even if you're working in the library, wherever it is that you work, whatever it is that you do, excuse me, whatever it is that you do, are you preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ mm-hmm. to all those that are around you? Mm-hmm. And then it says, he who has believed and has been baptized shall be saved, but he who has disbelieved shall be condemned. Mm-hmm. These signs accompany those who have believed in my name. They will cast out demons. They will speak in new tongues.
Yes.
They will pick up serpents. And if they drink any deadly poison, it will not hurt them. Yes. That's why, okay, as much as they said that about COVID, I said, Lord, you said in your word that if I drink any deadly poison, it's not going to harm me. Trust me, I went through my CDC guidelines. I cleaned my hands. There was a part of me in the beginning of COVID that I was a little bit fearful. My mother got COVID. My grandmother got COVID. There was a time that I couldn't see my mother. There was a time that I was like, Lord, what is going on? I believe in your word. I know that without a shadow of a doubt, you're going to heal them. And I praised the Lord that he did. And I pray that if somebody you knew was not healed, they got healed up in heaven.
Yes.
It was their time.
Exactly.
Okay. It was their time. But it says, and if they drink any deadly poison, it will not hurt them. They will lay hands on the sick and they will recover. If you don't know what's the calling, that is the calling.
Yes.
That is the calling. I want to tell you today that wherever you are at, if you don't know God, I am going to share him today with you. But I want to let you know that if you don't have a reason to live, this is the reason. That wherever you are at, you're going to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ to all creation. Man, I remember even from kindergarten, my parents always taught me that, you know, there's a lot of negative in the book, but there's also a lot of positive. I accepted the Lord as my personal savior very young in my life. Okay, very young. And another time I talked to my older daughter about this, she was like, oh, you're so weird. You're so unique. I don't know anybody like that. And I'm like, no, there's a lot of people like that. You just got to make that decision.
Yes.
Okay. There was a lot of violence in my house, but my sister and I made a decision. We were going to feel the Holy Spirit of God.
Yes.
We wanted to get closer to God. Yes. We wanted to feel his spirit.
Yes.
We know that although we didn't see everything perfect in our home, Jesus was the perfect
yes.
one. It wasn't the human. It was Jesus. Okay, and I remember feeling the Spirit of God and being filled with the baptized of yes. the Holy Ghost. I was like 5 or 6 or 7 years old, okay? And I remember seeing my parents leading and taking advantage of that. And I said, you know what? If they're feeling so happy when they're old there, well, how can I do that? How can I feel that Spirit of God? How can I feel that happiness and that joy that they're looking for?
Yeah,
something that I want my children to feel. And I'll tell you the testimony, and I spoke about it last week, the testimony with my younger daughter, with my 8-year-old. But I want to tell you, if you do not know why you're here, that is the reason why you are here. We are ambassadors of Jesus Christ. Okay, Jesus can use all his angels to go and preach the gospel, but he has chosen you. He has chosen me. He has chosen her to go and preach the gospel, and not just preach the gospel, but cast out demons, put your hands on the sick and for them to heal. How many of you want to be free, but free indeed, free for real? There's too many people in our churches today still in bondage when God has called us to be free. And the reason why we're not free is because we're not in his calling. We're not in his calling. We're too worried about social media and yes. what movie we're going to watch. And we need Netflix and Spotify and this and that and the other. And we forget that God has called us with a mission. And if you focus on the mission of yes. God, God is going to focus on your mission. And the reality is that we do not focus on what God wants us to focus on. So I read that, right?
Yes.
Mark 16:15-18. You will lay hands on the sick and they will recover. Amen. You will lay hands on those that are demon possessed. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. And you will cast out demons.
Yes.
You will drink poison, and it will not harm you.
Jesus.
Praise the Lord. How many of you want to be in that? It is time for a revival in the church. I'm so excited that on June 27th, we're actually going to go live. We're going to go live. House of Prayer and Restoration is going to go live. And I will share all the information. Follow me and you'll get it. We're going to be here in Elmsford, New York in the Hampton Inn, June 27th at 11:30. And we are going to be celebrating. We are going to be in revival. We are going to invite the Holy Spirit of God so that the people that don't know Jesus could walk in there and they could feel the kingdom of God all over them. Praise the Lord, because it's time for you to go to an exciting church and not a boring church. Okay, this is not about church, but it's about you, the temple of Jesus Christ. Okay, we're excited that we're finally going to be live, that we're going to be interacting with people. We're going to follow the CDC guidelines. We know that. We're going to go through all that, but understand that the Holy Spirit of God is going to fall like never before.
Yes.
And I want you to come if you can. It's going to be on June 27th, and I'll pin it on the Facebook. Hallelujah. But if you don't know what your calling is, that should be it.
Yes.
That's the global calling.
Yes. It's the calling for the church.
That's the global calling.
For this time.
For this time.
Para este tiempo.
For this time.
Dios quiere que nosotros le busquemos en espíritu y en verdad.
God wants us to look for him in spirit and in truth.
Que estemos llenos del Espíritu Santo.
That we can be filled of the Holy Spirit of God.
Que la unción del Espíritu Santo que rompe todo yugo sea la que esté sobre la vida de nosotros para que nosotros podamos ir a libertar a aquellos que están cautivos, sacar a aquellos que están en la cárcel. Y la sanar los quebrantados de corazón y la predicar las buenas nuevas. La gente tiene hambre y el único que puede cambiar su vida es el Evangelio de Jesucristo. Y que Jesucristo los llene con el poder del Espíritu Santo y que sean libres. Hay hombres, mujeres, cristianos, tanto tiempo con espíritu de pornografía, con espíritu de lost, tú sabes, ¿cómo se dice lost en español?
Perverso
y no pueden vencer. Hay gente que está buscando de Dios, pastores que están en droga, hermano, que ustedes no lo sepan, porque están atados, tienen espíritus, tienen atadura, y Dios ha llamado a la iglesia para que oremos los unos con los otros y para que esas cadenas se rompan, para que esos espíritus sean quebrantados y atados y echados fuera en el nombre de Jesús, porque el reino de los cielos, el Señor de Dios, el reino de los cielos está entre vosotros, y sabéis que el reino de los cielos cuando podamos echar fuera demonios y dejar libre a aquellos que están contigo en el nombre de Jesucristo.
Aleluya.
Porque el reino, esto es acerca del reino.
This is all about the kingdom.
Acerca del reino.
This is about the kingdom.
No es cuestión de have church. Sí, vamos a adorar a Dios, pero vamos a invocar la presencia del Espíritu Santo para que las vidas sean sanadas, para que las vidas que están atadas sean libertadas.
But let's seek the presence of God so that the people that are bound could be free. Come on now. So that the anointing of the Holy Spirit.
Yes, porque el Espíritu Santo es el que libera.
Because the Holy Spirit is the one that frees you. He's the one that liberates you. Hallelujah.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And we have to do that.
Yes.
It is time for the church to rise up and say, I want to be liberated.
Yes.
I want to be, hallelujah, the one to lay hands on the sick and for them to be healed through the Holy Spirit of God, through the name of Jesus. That's why people are lost. The Bible says they're going to run and nobody is following them. They're going to hide and nobody's looking for them. And now it is time, without a shadow of a doubt, for us to lay hands on the sick and for them to be healed, for us to cast out demons in the name of Jesus, for people to be free.
Yes.
You know, aren't you tired of being in bondage? Aren't you tired of struggling with pornography? Aren't you tired of struggling with lust? There's pastors that are in drugs. There's pastors that don't know what they're doing. There's people that have, you know, lost their way, although they've been in ministry. It is time to find your way.
Yes.
This is what we're talking about. Why you needed to be born.
Amen.
Why you needed to be born. There's still space in this world for you.
Yes.
God has given you a destiny different from everybody else's destiny.
Yes.
And you might say, oh, well, how am I going to do it? Social media is full. Everything is saturated. No. Everybody has been given a different DNA. Everybody has been given different fingerprints. Everybody has been chosen for something different.
Yes.
And you got to find what it is for you. But a lot of times you don't find it because we're not doing the global calling.
Exactly.
The global calling is what I just read in Mark, right? 16:15, we are his disciples.
Los principios del reino,
we need to follow the kingdom
la presencia del Espíritu Santo,
and we need to ask for the Holy Spirit of
para
God
que haya liberación y restauración y salvación en las vidas.
So that there could be liberation, salvation, hallelujah,
yes,
in people's lives.
Amen, amen.
Why do I talk about this?
Yes.
When I was writing this book, I was at awe. I didn't know what to do. I was like, what am I doing here? You know, I don't know how to write. I don't have resources. I don't have a publishing company. I don't have, you know, marketing. I don't have anything. I don't have anybody. Okay. All I knew was that I had a burning desire, and I knew without a shadow of a doubt that God had called me to share a story that was going to liberate and restore, yes, and restore families all over this world. It was scary. There's no other author in my family. I'm the only one. But God has called me. Yes. To pave a way and for people to follow. And for many of you that are listening today, God has called you to pave the way. God has called you to be the first one. Don't be scared.
Yes.
Don't be scared. Fear is not of God. You see, the devil comes to steal. He's trying to steal your peace by putting fear in your heart. That's not of God. And for you to say, oh, wow, what, you know, I have a podcast, you know, be happy with your haters. Whatever you do, whether it's good or bad, you're going to have haters. Bottom line. There's always going to be people that aren't going to like you. There's always going to be people that are going to unfollow you. There's always going to be people. Do it anyway.
Yes.
God will find the people that are supposed to connect to you.
Yes.
You have a unique voice. So you got to find what it is for you.
Yes.
And I want to share that because I feel, you know, mm-hmm, that you will find your individual calling. You will find your individual destiny when you do the global calling.
Yes.
Okay. When you do the global calling. So for a long time, you know, I have been behind the scenes for a very long time. I have been in ministry since I'm in my teens and since I was a kid. Mm-hmm. I was in children's ministry, youth ministry, this ministry, that ministry, Sunday school teacher, doing this, doing that, but I've always been behind the scenes. And I did not know that God was going to use this book to kind of cast me out there to the world. I didn't know that. Mm-hmm. All I knew was that I was in obedience.
Amen.
All I knew was when I was in my prayer closet, that's a big tip right there. When I was in my prayer and God was putting that fire in my soul that I needed to do something,
yes,
and write this book, that all I was doing was being in obedience, although I didn't have the resources and I didn't know what I was doing.
Exactly.
And I want to share that with each and every one of you because you need to know that you have a purpose in this world.
Oh, yes.
You have a destiny. We're not here as a coincidence.
Ni por un accidente.
Or an accident.
No importa cómo naciste.
It doesn't matter how you were born.
Dios te tiene a ti con un propósito.
God has you here with a purpose.
El propósito más grande es que tú lo conozcas a él.
And the biggest purpose is for you to know him.
Que tú recibas el amor que él tiene para tu
that
vida.
You can receive the love of God that he has for you.
Que tú sepas cuál es tu ADN, quién eres tú en Dios, y que Dios te use para la gloria y la honra de su
that manera. You know what your DNA is and that God can use you for his glory and his honor.
Porque no tenemos que buscar nuestra identidad en ningún hombre, ni en ninguna mujer,
yes,
ni en el dinero, ni en el material. Nuestra identidad está en Cristo, que fue el que nos hizo. Aleluya, que a través de su sacrificio nosotros fuéramos hijos de Dios.
Yes. That we know that in the midst of the sacrifice of Jesus Christ, that you are a child chosen by
Amen.
God.
Amen.
So I didn't even realize it was 7:45. I'm just, you know, like preaching.
Yes.
Down.
Yes.
But I want to tell you one thing. How do you start? Some of you might say, well, why was I born? I really don't know. How do you start kind of figuring out how you were born? I'm going to give you the first step. I remember a year before or 7 or 8 months before, I got to get better with dates. I was taking my younger daughter to preschool or kindergarten, I think it was. And her kindergarten was her school, thank God, is right around where I live. I walk there, I come back. And long story short, I'm praying and I start talking in tongues while I'm walking. And I tell the Lord, I completely surrender to you.
Amen.
I didn't know what I was saying. I was just, I surrender to you, God, right? If God gives you the whole picture, you probably might reserve yourself a little bit. You'd be like, wait, right? And I started praying to the Lord, and I was telling the Lord, I surrender to you. I surrender all that I am to you. And God was like, are you serious? And I was like, yeah, I'm serious. And the Bible says this, you know, a lot of times we're trying to juggle, right? What our career with our calling, with our hobbies. We're trying to juggle all that together. Like, you know, not necessarily your career is your calling. You might be a doctor, but your calling might be to teach in Sunday school, mm-hmm. you know? But God might be using you also as a doctor.
Yes.
Okay. Or, you know, you might be a business person, but God is going to use you to preach in a pulpit, or God is using you to preach to those in the, you know, in your business. And, you know, so we got to kind of juggle and figure out, okay, what's my calling? What's my career? What are my hobbies? How do I juggle it all, right? How do I figure it out? But the first thing to find out your calling and your purpose and why you were born is to surrender to God.
Yes.
And it says in Romans 12:1-2, therefore I urge you, brothers, yes. on account of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as living sacrifices, holy and pleasing to God, which is your spiritual service of worship. Do not, and then after that, it says, give it up all to him. Give up your body, right? The Bible says that you are created with his likeness and image.
Yes.
So he's telling you, give it up. I made you, but I'm telling you that you willingly have to give up what I made.
Amen.
I created you before the foundations of this world, and I'm gonna give you the ability to basically surrender everything that I have given you, because I created you, right? I created you. And then after that, he says, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what is the good, pleasing, and perfect will of God. How many of you know that God wants you to know his perfect will?
Yes.
Why were you created? He wants you to know your perfect will. He wants you to live in his perfect will. Just remember that the only way you're going to renew your mind is through the Holy Spirit of God.
Yes.
You could read every positive book you want. You could, you know, be around positive people. It's not positivity that's going to renew your mind. Yes. What's going to renew your mind is the Holy Spirit of God.
Yes.
That's what renews your mind. Yeah, all the positive books are great. Being around positive people is awesome. Reading great books is awesome. But you need to read the Word of God.
That's the key.
Because you could do all the positive, right? This is not knowing. Take it easy. The Holy Spirit is what renews your mind.
Yes.
It is what makes you understand, wow, I was wrong and God is convicting me and I need to go this way.
Yes.
Oh, wow, I thought the career path for me was this way, but the Holy Spirit is pulling me that way.
Yes.
I thought my calling was to teach, but my calling is really to preach. I thought my calling was to do this, but it's really to do that. And the Holy Spirit of God will guide you. The Holy Spirit of God will tell you exactly what you need to do if you are connected with him. Amen.
Amen.
Okay. It says, so number one is surrendering to God. Why is it that you don't know what you need to do? Because you haven't surrendered yet. You have not surrendered to God completely to realize what it is that you need to do. You know, the best part is to combine all three, your calling, your hobby, and your career, right? For some people, eventually, I would like to make this a career, but I have another career besides being alive. Okay. But for some people, this is all they do. They're on live. They're on TV. They do that. This becomes part of their life. And you combine all of them to one, which is awesome. But God started telling me, listen, go out there. And somebody told me, Gina, you know, you're really good in front of the camera. Why don't you do that? And I said, you know what? Okay, let's do it. It wasn't something that I planned. It wasn't something that I was like, oh, this is what I'm going to do. And I'm going to make money doing it. I don't make any money doing this. I don't worry about money. So if that's what you're thinking about, rebuke yourself, because I'm not worried about money. God is the owner of riches. He's provided until now, and he will continue to provide. And when he provides good.
Oh, yes.
He provides good. So I'm worried about that. But what I do want to tell you is that you need to surrender. You need to renew your mind. And number one, surrender to find your calling. Renew your mind to find your calling. Number three, stay humble.
Yes.
Stay humble.
Yes.
You know, I've never been one for title. I've been pastoring with my mom. I've been a reverend for a very long time. And I never even told anybody.
Yeah.
I don't even remember. Like, do you have a ministry? You're a pastor? I stay sitting down. I just experienced that. And I'm like, why did I sit down? I mean, I'm a pastor with my mom. But it doesn't faze me. Because it's not about title. Yes. God is not looking for title.
Yes.
He's looking for a constrict heart.
Yes.
He's looking for a heart that surrenders to him, that gives him everything, that you could give him everything that you are so that he could use you as a vessel for his purpose.
Yes.
And then anything else you want, he's going to take care of your family. He's going to take care of everything else.
Yes.
But why were you created? What is your calling? What is your destiny? Why are you here? You know? For some people, it's a different career path. But whatever God has called you to do, make sure that you do the global calling, which is to talk to everybody about God.
Yeah. To preach the gospel.
It says in Romans 1:3, for by grace given me, I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought.
Yes.
Stay humble. Stay humble. But think of yourself with sober judgment according to the measure of faith God has given you. You see, God gives a measure of faith for everyone, a different measure of faith. God gave a different measure of faith for my mom for healing. God has given me a different measure of faith for prosperity in different areas, in finances and business and stuff like that. And we feed off each other, right? We are one body. You know, when I remember when I thought that I might have had breast cancer and I'm in the hospital and my husband is there, my mother's there, and my mother's laughing, okay? And she's like, Gina, you good. I was trembling, about to pass out, okay? We were in the sauna. I mean, literally, I'm not even joking. I was about to fall on the floor because God was taking me to another level of faith in that area, okay? In that area. And my mother was like, Gina, yo me levanté hoy. I woke up today. You're fine. What did you tell me?
Tengo un gozo en mi
corazón. I have such a joy in my heart.
Y ella estaba temblando porque iba para que le verificaran si ella tenía cáncer en el seno. Y ustedes saben que yo tuve también cáncer en el seno y Dios me sanó.
So,
y ese día el Espíritu Santo ministró a mi vida y me dijo, contenta que está todo bien. Y dije, Gina, estoy bien feliz. Y ella me miró así como dice, ¿qué está pasando?
Like, what is wrong with this woman? But I tell you, that's a different measure of faith, right? I'm telling myself. So I already had gone through different processes for people that have had, you know, breast cancer survivors, you know, God bless you. My mother had breast cancer and God healed her and she went through the process. She had surgery, radiation and all that. And, you know, the doctor kept on checking me. Long story short, I was going for my final appointment to do a biopsy. And I was literally about to pass out. I was just like, I can't breathe. It was crazy. All right. If you ever gone through that type of panic or anxiety, and, you know, I'm not thinking of me, I'm thinking of my children. You know, my daughter was like 6 years old at the time or 5 years old. And then I had my older baby that was probably like 16 or 17. And my mother looks at me and she was like, I have such a joy in my heart. Take it easy. And I was like, yo, this woman is not inconsiderate. Like, what? You know? And she goes, Gina, I woke up today and I have such a joy. You're going to be fine. And I'll tell you about that testimony. I go in the operating room and, you know, they start looking at me and I'm literally trembling, but I'm like, I'm healed in the name of Jesus. I'm healed. I have nothing. I'm confessing that with my mind. And although I didn't feel that because I wanted to pass out. And I remember them doing the last mammogram and the doctor walks in and says, we made a mistake. They were about to put a knife, okay, to do a biopsy. They already had put the line. They already had done everything that they said. Oh, I think it was that we used the wrong mammogram machine.
Yeah, right. Mm-hmm.
And I was took at that moment, all my tears started coming down. The lady looked at me like, you're supposed to be happy. But at that moment, I started crying and crying and crying. I was laying down while they were checking me. And she walked out, she gave me a napkin. And then the lady tells me, you always should listen to your mom because they're always right. And I said, I thank God that I do. Because I do. She could tell you. Mm-hmm. I listen to my mom. Mm-hmm. Okay. And I remember, oh my God, it was crazy. But then God has given me a different measure of faith, right? Where my mother never thought she could get a condo. And I was like, mom, you're going to get a condo. But I'm 60 something years old. I don't have any money. I don't have a W-2. Mm-hmm. Okay. Cause she's a pastor. She works for the church. And I was like, mom, you good. So she's flipping out. She has no idea what I'm doing internally with the finances, with paperwork, with banks. If you ever own a home, you know how crazy it is sometimes. And I'm chilling and my mother's flipped. I'm not even telling her what's going on because she will flip out even more. And so God gives us a different measure of faith.
Yes.
If we stay humble.
Eso que necesitamos en una
otra. That's why we need each other.
Yes.
And I want to tell you that you were created for greatness. And you will find your calling and you will find your destiny if you really seek it. You see, the Bible says seek and you will find. Yes. Knock and the door will be open. Not enough of you are desperate. Call.
And I respond.
Right? Call and I'll respond.
Yes.
Call and I will answer.
Yes.
And I want to tell you today that with those three steps, you're going to find your destiny and your calling.
Yes.
And you know, maybe your career is part of your calling. Maybe it's not. You got to figure that out for yourself. Right? I involve everything in what I do. Everything. I remember it in elementary school, junior high school, college. If you were my friend, you came to church with me.
Yes.
That was like rule of thumb. You're my best friend. I'm going to church on Sunday. I'm going to pick you up. What do you mean? Yeah, my parents are pastors. We're going to church. All of my friends. If you watch this live and you were part of my friends when we were in elementary school, high school, I want you to type on here because people don't believe me. If you were my friend, you came to church with me. Okay? And most of them to this day are still serving the Lord.
Amen.
And I want to say that I contributed a little bit to that when I was young. Okay? And that my parents contributed to that. But the glory and honor is to God because all I was doing was the global calling of preaching the word of God because there was a joy inside of me. I remember jumping up and down and saying, oh my God, do you remember mommy when I went up to you and I said, mommy, I don't want to leave church. Let's go to another service.
That's how we
did with Jaylen. So it was like a duplicate here. We went to a service. And if they listening, God bless you. We went to a deliverance service and God has been taking us really this ministry to another level. And we go to that deliverance service and we had already been talking to Jaylen about speaking in different tongues, about, you know, being baptized in the Holy Spirit. It's important that you speak to your children. Okay.
Yes.
And we were already talking to her about living a Christian life and reading the word of God and all that. And there was already weeks of that. She already has spoken like a little bit of tongues. Like Saturday mornings, we wake up and we just worshiping for hours. And I saw her like, you know, like talking a little bit. Mm-hmm. But the day after we went to that church, amazing church, in a deliverance service, mm-hmm. Pastor Alexander Pagani, we go to his church. And the next day we're talking and, we're talking about rebuking demons and that she has the authority. I don't care how old she is. It has nothing to do with her age. She's 8 years old, right? For those that don't know. And she starts talking. All of a sudden she stands up as we praying before she's about to go to sleep. And she's like, mommy, I have the authority to rebuke demons. And I wanna go back to the church and I wanna go back to our church and you know, because we're having a live service on June 27th at 11:30 in the Hampton Inn. I'm announcing it because I hope to see some of you guys. And in Elmsford, New York, in Hampton Inn. I'll pin it later. But she turns around and she goes, and I feel the Holy Spirit of God. And she starts worshiping God and boom, she starts talking in tongues.
Hallelujah.
Oh my God. And she starts talking in tongues and she starts jumping up and down and she's running all around the room. And she's like, mommy, I feel God. I feel God. I know how you feel. Oh my God, this joy. And she started apologizing for me for like being a kid, you know, for sometimes not obeying me. Or she was like, no, I will obey you. I will obey daddy. I'm going to do what you guys tell me to do. And she started worshiping. And oh my God, it was just another level of glory in our room. And then I started talking in tongues and she was crying and hugging me. And my husband went upstairs and he's like, what is going on? I'm like, she's talking in tongues. And I wish I would have taken video of it. I just didn't want to mess up the moment, you know. And I took a little video of her towards that end. She was like, I see millions of angels. I see angels in this room. I see two angels in the door, and I seen those angels, by the way. Yeah. I see angels over here, over there. I'm gonna, you know, she sleeps with us a lot, so she's like, I'm gonna give you and daddy you know, privacy, and I'm gonna listen to you guys. And it was like a whole character change. Yes. Because now the Holy Spirit of God was there.
Wow.
It was amazing. I hope you got something out of this, because why you needed to be born, it was because you're great. And God has a destiny for you.
Amen.
And a purpose for you. And I want to tell you that God, wow. God wants you to be free. God wants you to be free. He doesn't want you to be a Christian that's bound. He doesn't want you to be a person that's bound, whether you're Christian or not. He wants you to be free.
Amen.
You want to say one last word, Mom?
Yes. Amen. Así que, naciste con un propósito.
You were born with a purpose.
El propósito más grande que puedas tener una relación personal con Jesucristo.
And the biggest purpose is for you to have a relationship with Jesus Christ.
El Señor dice en su palabra que sin él nada podemos hacer.
The Bible says that without him we can't do anything.
Y Jesús lo dijo, sin mí ustedes nada pueden hacer.
Jesus said it, without you nothing you can do nothing.
Without him. You know, because lo necesitamos en todo lo que hacemos.
Because we need him in all that we do.
Y queremos ver la gloria de Dios en nuestras vidas.
And we want to see the glory of God.
Queremos ser instrumentos útiles para su reino.
We want to be a instrument for his glory.
For his kingdom.
For his kingdom.
Y Dios quiere bendecir nuestras vidas.
And God wants to bless our lives.
Y sabemos que para este tiempo Dios nos ha llamado. Dios tiene cosas grandes que hacer a través de nuestras vidas para que nosotros vayamos a libertar y a salvar a aquellos que están perdidos.
And I know that without a shadow of a doubt that God has given us the authority to liberate. Hallelujah.
Y para all those that are saved.
And save those that are lost.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Dios te bendiga. En esta noche yo me he gozado conmigo. Yo siempre me gozo con ella.
God bless you. Today I have had a good time with my daughter. You know, I pray to the Lord because God is just taking us to another dimension in our life. And I want you to understand, man, that God has such a beautiful destiny for you.
Hallelujah.
I don't care who you are. I don't care where you came from. I don't care your past. I don't care any of that. What God cares is what you're doing now.
Yes.
What God cares is, you know, surrender to God and ask God, listen, I surrender. I give you everything that I am and I'm starting over. And you know what God will do? He will start over. Yes. That's the beauty of our Lord.
Yes.
That's the beauty of Jesus dying on the cross of Calvary for each and every one of us. So that today we can have a chance to start over.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Next week, episode 45, we are talking about the process of finding your own faith. That's chapter 6 in the book. And why did I speak about this? I spoke about it because a lot of people are in their faith because of their parents. It doesn't have to be Christianity. It could be any faith, right? It could be any religion. But I want to talk to you about the process of me finding my faith.
Yes.
And how it contributed, how my parents contributed to it in such a positive way. Because, you know, life could be very bad to you, but there's always a light in the end of the tunnel. And it's up to you if you want to see that light.
Yes.
There's always two sides.
Okay.
Always.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. So let's make a prayer for all those that want to receive illumination from God for their calling.
Yes.
Okay. That they're tired of just living a mundane life and they want to without a shadow of a doubt.
Yes.
Without a shadow of a doubt. Jesus. They want to know what their will is. And the Holy Spirit of God is here. I know that God is here. I know that God is just doing some amazing, amazing things, which each and every one of us, you know, I want you to just raise your hands to the sky and say, Lord, Lord, talk to me about what my calling is. While I'm going through this, I'm going to do my global calling of preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ, healing the sick through your name, Jesus, casting out demons through your name, Jesus, while you show me exactly what I need to do. While you show me exactly what my destiny is. You know, your destiny could be something different depending on what process you are in your life.
Yes.
Just make sure that whatever process you are in, you are in your destiny.
Yes.
And I want to worship the Lord. And if you've been touched today, just let me know. You know, I've gotten so many messages from people saying, wow, Gina, you touched me. Wow, the word that you said. And that's how I know that I'm doing the right thing with the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
If I didn't get anybody, if I didn't get, you know, maybe I'm wasting my time. But there's somebody that's connected to our voice.
Yes.
And I want to pray over you, the anointing of God over each and every one of person that's listening to me today. And I want the Holy Spirit of God to guide you and tell you exactly what you need to do and where you need to go.
Yes. Hallelujah.
And you need to start now with what God is calling you to do.
In, nombre de Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
God bless you all. It's just a beauty to see what God is doing. And I want to bless every one of you guys. I want to bless you for sharing. I want to bless you for, you know, just letting people know, hey, there's somebody out there. There's a crazy Puerto Rican girl that wants to you know, tell you that you're worth it through Jesus Christ.
Oh, yes. Amen.
Amen. God bless you. This is Genaria Arcecado and Reverend Iluminada Roman. You could just call me Gina. I'm fine with Gina. God bless you so much. Next week, the process of finding your own faith. I want you to tune in. I want you to share it with people. I want you to share my flyer with people. Let them know, hey, you got to listen to this crazy girl. Because if you don't know your destiny, you will find it out when you read this book. Now, I want to let you know that the workbook is out for the Prevail. We did the workbook. If you want it, just DM me, just message me, let me know, hey, I would like your workbook. If you already read the book, I will send you the workbook. It's completely free. It's free of charge. In 2 weeks, hopefully I will have the Spanish workbook out. And you'll be able to identify what areas you need to work on and how to break generational curses in your life and how to become the best you that God created you to be.
Yes.
Amen. God bless you all. And I will talk to you next week.
Amen.
Yes. That's awesome.